Women are hiding their sexuality because they don't trust men. Women are afraid to be hurt. Although consciously they want to find their Mr. Right, subconsciously they avoid it because they are afraid of men. They are afraid to be attractive and sexy because they cannot trust men. Number five, same with men. They are hiding their sexuality because men don't trust women. If a man was raised by an emotionally unavailable mother, he cannot trust women. He can take on the role of a player and date many women instead. This way, he can avoid commitment. This way, he is in charge. He is the one who initiates a breakup or just simply disappears from a woman's life. It's not because he is a bad guy, but mostly because he cannot trust women. He cannot create a healthy, loving relationship. He is afraid of commitment. He is avoiding it. People often don't allow themselves to connect to their true feelings. They don't allow themselves to fall in love because they are afraid to be vulnerable. They are afraid that another person will break their heart. In order for a person to hide his sexuality, they have to suppress their true feelings and emotions. One of the easiest ways to do it is with food. Food helps us to refocus our brain. Food has different flavors, textures, and temperature. Therefore, we can experience a wide variety of sensations when we eat. We all know that food brings emotional and physical pleasure. This is the perfect substitute for sexuality. What influences the formation of our sexuality? The answer lies with our parents, of course, in our childhood. The way they express their sexuality, the words they use towards each other, the words and reactions they use toward you, the comments they made about your body, about your clothes, about your appearance, the amount of hugs, kisses, and affection you had in your family. The same-sex parent teaches a child how to treat themselves and accept their own body. The opposite sex parent gives a child a confirmation on his sexuality. For example, when a mother says proud words to her son, when she compliments his intelligence, his bravery, she is confirming his masculinity. When a father says to his daughter that she is beautiful, she is his princess, he is confirming her charm and her femininity. By observing the way our parents treat each other, we receive a confirmation or criticism regarding our femininity or masculinity. We pick up on words they use behind each other's backs and how they address each other every day. I have a separate webinar entitled Four Types of Women, Father-Daughter Relationships. I will add the link in the video description. In that webinar, I talk in details about four important stages of forming female sexuality and role of the father in that process. Please check the link below the video and watch that webinar.